Hi folks, Matt Easton here, Scholar Gladiator here. Now I spend a lot of time on my channel talking about medieval swords, and I'm sure that I have mentioned dozens of times, perhaps even scores, Ewart Oakeshott, who unfortunately is no longer with us, but he was pretty much, well, let's face it, the most important person to write about medieval swords ever since history began. And you know, he several works. The Archaeology of Weapons is probably, if you're going to buy one Ewart Oakeshott book, buy The Archaeology of Weapons, which I don't have in my hands at the moment, it's over there on my bookshelf. But in terms of medieval swords specifically, so The Archaeology of Weapons talks about quite a broad period, and it talks about various different weapons and armor and all sorts. But specifically talking about medieval swords, primarily after 1000 AD. So there are other books which focus on migration and Viking era swords, but specifically looking at 1000 AD, let's say to 1500 AD. These books by Ewart Oakeshott, so the records of the medieval sword and the sword in the age of chivalry. Oakeshott did write other books as well, some of which kind of overlap in knowledge, some give extra information that aren't in these two. But really, the one that I would point anyone to, if you want to learn about medieval swords or get started on the subject, get serious about it, obviously you can find a lot on the internet these days without having to buy any book at all. And I would recommend My Armoury, incidentally, if you want to really break into the subject, have a look on My Armoury, which is pretty much the best and only surviving forum. Back in the day, there used to be lots of forums for this sort of subject, but My Armoury is the only one really which has survived and is still flourishing. And there are a lot of very good articles on My Armoury, which I'd highly recommend you reading through. And the information on My Armoury will overlap with the information in these books. But if you want to get one book, get this one, Records of the Medieval Sword. But what I really want to say in this video is, come on people, we need to push the research forward. Like, what are people doing? There are some really great people out there doing really good cutting edge research, which has built upon, and in many cases, interlaced and interlocked with what Ewart Oakeshott wrote about, for example, in Park Lane Arms Fair catalogues, which were quite seminally important in their time for new research and articles on the subject, as well as Archaeologia and other publications. But there are people like Clive Thomas, Neil Melville, James Elmsley, who've done really great leading edge research on medieval swords. Fabrice Cognot as well, and various other people. I can't mention everyone, but there's probably 20 people who are alive and not old at the moment, who have years of work ahead of them, who should be publishing more. Now, some of these have published articles in Park Lane Arms Fair catalogue and in other places. And in some cases, have even published small books, but we really need hefty, big books on medieval swords. And the thing is, back in the day when Ewart Oakeshott was publishing, I would argue it was harder to get a book into print because there were fewer people had the time and the resources and the spare time, you know, to make it, to research and write a book. So, you know, to have the knowledge to do it. But equally, you had to go down an old-fashioned route of publishing, which is really far harder, far more challenging to actually get something to print than the modern world. In the modern world, you know, at the most basic level, you can just publish stuff on a website. You can publish through Lulu or on something like Amazon Books even. There are many different ways you can self-publish. But in addition, there are lots of small publishing companies like Fallen Rook or, there's loads of small publishing companies. Look at any of the HEMA publications and see who those are published through, that you can get these sorts of books published with, and they can get onto Amazon, they can get onto bookshelves in Waterstones. So, you know, you can do it easily. And I know too many people who are doing great research and even publishing things in, you know, small essays and maybe articles online, maybe in periodicals and stuff like this, but they're not, they're essentially sitting on too much of their research. Not, and I don't mean that in a critical way, not like they're sitting on it because they're keeping it to themselves, but I think for fear of publishing. And I put myself in that category as well. I don't have any intentions to publish on medieval weapons at the moment, but I do. I am writing things and I am publishing on 19th century stuff. And I'm guilty of this as well. And there are two main reasons. One publication falls into the category of I keep finding new things, and so I keep essentially rewriting it. And the other publication falls more into the category of I just don't have time to finish this goddamn thing. And it is difficult. It's difficult if it's not your job, if your job's not a writer, if your main job is whatever it is, an academic or an antique dealer or a YouTuber, or if you, you know, I was a civil servant previously, or whatever you do, you know, if you work in a cafe or you work in a factory or whatever, car mechanic, you have a day job. It is difficult to then find the time in your you know, recreational or spare time, what could be family time, or just doing general admin like paying the bills or whatever, to have time to do things, luxuries like writing books. But the point I want to make is we now know a lot more information than is contained in the seminal work on medieval swords, which is by Ewart Oakeshott, Records of the Medieval Sword. We know that lots of the information in this book, sorry Ewart Oakeshott, you were amazing and you did great things, but lots of the information in here is now known to be wrong. Lots of the measurements are wrong in here, the weights are wrong, some of the proportions are wrong. So, you know, it needs updating. Someone needs to bite the bullet, and even if it's not as big as this, even if you think, okay, well, I don't have everything ready to publish a book of this size, I will do it, but it'll be another 5 or 10 years. Please don't just wait and wait and wait, because it'll never get done. Look at what you've got, publish that, and then look at publishing other things. That's what Ewart Oakeshott did throughout his whole career. He started publishing at a relatively young age. If you look back into history, if you look at someone like Alfred Hutton as well, he started publishing in his 20s. I would say publish what you have and then move on from there. You know, release updates, release looking at slightly different aspects of the thing or specific aspects, but get publishing, get the stuff out there in whatever way you can. I wish you all the very best luck. And I hope that one of you out there is the next Ewart Oakeshott, because we need someone to step into his shoes. Or preferably, we need 5 people to step into his shoes and start publishing good books that you can buy from Amazon or Waterstones or wherever on medieval swords, because we're still working from 1980s books here and older. Okay, so we need some new stuff. Please publish it. If I can be of any help in any way that I can, then of course, even if it's just promoting it on this channel, you know that I'm always happy to do that. Thanks for watching. Share your thoughts below. Maybe share your information about things that have been published, maybe books that you would recommend to other people looking at this video. I've probably got a couple of recommendations myself, which I might do reviews of soon, actually. Thanks for watching. Give us a like and a subscribe, and I'll see you soon for another video. Cheers, folks. Thanks for watching. We've got extra videos on Patreon. Please give our Facebook a like and subscribe if you haven't already. Cheers, folks.